to my channel.
If you guys are new here, welcome. My name is Hannah and I'm a first year medical student. On my channel, I do a lot of videos talking about my life in medical school, but I'm also a huge reader, and today I'm very excited to share with you my favorite books of 2020. This year, I read a total of 58 books and I thought I would talk you guys through some of my all-time favorites from this year. I will leave all the titles down below in case you want to check it out. And I also do have a Goodreads which I use to track the books. So if you're interested in seeing every single book that I read and what rating I gave it, then I will have that linked down below as well. But anyway, without much further ado, I'm just going to jump into my favorite books. So I hope that this video gives you some ideas for what book you want to pick up next. I would love it if you would share with me some of your favorite books because I am always looking for new genres and new recommendations. So in no particular order, the first book that I want to talk about is Pale Fire by Vladimir Nabokov. I love Nabokov's writing. The only other book that I've read by him is Lolita, which is a controversial piece of work, but I don't think one can deny how exquisitely Nabokov writes and constructs his storylines. Pale Fire is no different. I definitely found myself bookmarking and underlining certain passages that just had beautiful language. The first part of Pale Fire is actually a poem, and the second part of the story is a commentary on that poem. And that might sound a little bit confusing since this is a work of fiction, but you find out that the person who is providing the commentary on this poem is a huge fanatic of the poet. And in his commentary, you can read between the lines and discover a really interesting story between the people that is talked about within the poem as well as within the poet's life. So I really don't want to spoil anything, so I'm not going to talk about it too much. I just have to say I really recommend it. It's best to go in not really knowing anything. So much political scandal and drama and humor within this novel. It was extremely witty and clever and fun to read. The next book I have to talk about is The Collected Schizophrenias by Esme, Weijun, Wang. I was really intrigued to pick this book up because first of all, the cover is absolutely beautiful, but I also majored in neuroscience in my undergraduate degree and I always found schizophrenia to be one of those very elusive and ambiguous mental illnesses. So Esme herself was first diagnosed with bipolar disorder, then schizoaffective personality disorder, and then finally schizophrenia. And she provides an extremely vulnerable and insightful perspective on what it is like to be someone who encounters this diagnosis, and honestly, how confusing it is. Something I never really thought about was how arbitrary the guidelines for these diagnoses are. Mental illness is obviously not something that is easily quantifiable or observable, so hearing her talk about the struggles of trying to figure out what her diagnosis is and how she identified herself within that diagnosis was really interesting. Together, these essays really highlight what her life looked like before, during, and after her diagnosis. And I have to say that there were some passages that were extremely heartbreaking to read, but also just very powerful because Esme was so vulnerable with the mental struggles that she lived through and how this diagnosis has impacted her life and her future. If you are someone who wants to gain a perspective on living with mental illness, I think this would be a great read. I also highly recommend this to anyone studying psychology, neuroscience, or a related field because this provides such a human perspective on a generic diagnosis, and I think that we can all appreciate that a lot. The third book that I have to recommend is actually a graphic novel series. During quarantine, I really wanted to expose myself to some new genres, and I don't read a lot of graphic novels, so I picked up Saga by Brian Vaughan and Fiona Staples. This is the bind up version that contains all 9 volumes that are currently out, and I love this so much. This is my baby. I have forced so many people to read this book and they all loved it. The art style is just so amazing and it is just so much fun to read through. I love having this on my shelf and even just flipping through it, I think the art is so eye-catching and bold and fun. It follows a planet that is at war with one of its satellite moons. However, this war has basically expanded to involve other bystanders within the galaxy to the point where it is an intergalactic war. So this story primarily focuses on an unexpected love story that unfolds between two individuals from these opposing sides and how they manage to build a life together within the crazy chaos of this war-torn galaxy. I wasn't expecting a graphic novel to explore so many deep concepts about morality, about violence, and its consequences, but the story just completely blew me away with the storytelling. I was so invested in the characters, and I highly recommend that you pick up the huge bind-up edition because I can promise you that once you get started, you will want to binge every single book. It is just that fast-paced and that addicting. So if you haven't picked this up already, please check this out. Going back to some of my fictional loves, another book that I loved is Severance by Ling Ma. This book was on my TBR when it first came out, but then I never got around to it. I was kind of losing interest, but then I finally picked it up during quarantine this year, and I am so glad I did. Okay, the premise of this book is really interesting. There was some sort of bat-originating virus that infects people and basically turns them into zombies. These are not the brain-eating zombies. These people become basically stuck in everyday routines until they die. And we follow our main protagonist who has to navigate this world with a small ragtag team of survivors while also trying to hide the fact that she is pregnant in this apocalyptic world. We don't know how this virus is spread. There doesn't seem to be a cure. There's a lot of unknowns within the story. I think the author also did a really interesting job exploring what we view humanity and living as. Think about when we are going through our lives every single day. Are we truly living or are we just fulfilling a capitalist agenda? I know, big political ideas being thrown out there, but I think this book was so much fun, and if you're looking for a quick read, this book is not super long, you should definitely pick this up. Next, I would like to talk about a few of the fantasy series that I absolutely loved. So most recently, I read the first two books of the Poppy War series. That includes The Poppy Wars and The Dragon Republic by R.F. Kuang. I'm still waiting to get my hands on the third book. I really want to get it in a paperback so that I can complete the set, so that's why I am waiting to pick that one up. But I absolutely love this series. It's probably one of the best fantasy series that I have ever read. So these novels are loosely based on the Sino-Japanese War, which I didn't know much about, so it was actually really cool to read up more on the background history of these books. But I totally recognize some of the cultural influences as someone from a Chinese background myself, so it was really cool to see that in a fantasy novel, because most fantasy novels are from a Western perspective. So again, I'm really loving all the diverse perspectives of the books that I've read this year. Really appreciating that representation. Anyway, back to these books. We follow our main character, Rin, who achieves a really high score on a nationwide exam that allows her to attend an extremely prestigious military school. However, during the first half of this book, an actual war breaks out. What I found extremely profound and meaningful within this book was that R.F. Kuang does such a good job explaining the strategy and decision making. This is an extremely dark and gruesome novel because R.F. Kuang does not shy away from talking about how atrocious and violent war can be. The consequences for the bystanders, the civilians, and the soldiers are explicit. So know that going in, this can be extremely dark and violent and hard to read at times, but I think that by making us face the consequences of war, she's providing us with a really insightful look into what war actually feels like and how heavy it is on the heart. That also makes it easier for us to relate to the characters in this novel who are going through it themselves and have to deal with the consequences that their actions have on both themselves and everyone around them. That is the premise of the first book, and the story continues on in the second book. I cannot speak highly about this novel enough. Like, I could honestly talk about this book for hours because there is so much that is refreshing and unique about this series. And I don't mean to pick favorites, but if there is any one book that I have to recommend as a must read from this list, it's gotta be this book. Another epic fantasy book that I loved is The Priory of the Orange Tree by Samantha Shannon. Oh, love this book so much. I honestly want to reread it because, as you can tell, it's a hefty book and I just want to experience it all again. So obviously, dragons play an important role in this book. On one hand, we have one culture who views dragons as demons, and we have another that worships them. There's a history of a major war where the dragons were finally put to sleep, and the dragons haven't been around much since then. However, it appears that the dragons are waking up now, so there is the sense of an impending war with the dragons once more. In order to survive, these cultures will basically have to team up, so we focus on how they're able to overcome these differences. While that is the broad storyline, I think the main selling point of this book is the strong female characters that come from each of these different cultures. I thought it was so cool to see the central role that women were given in this book. We have one kingdom where there exists a matriarchy, and we just have a wonderful set of diverse, opinionated, and strong women. I love the diverse cast of characters in the story. I loved the intertwining storylines, and I am so glad that I picked this book up. And finally, the last book that I wanted to talk about was actually the most recent book that I just completed, and I've heard so much buzz about this book, and I wasn't sure I wanted to pick it up, but I'm so glad I did. And that book is The Vanishing Half by Brit, Bennett. This book is filled with so much nuance. It just provoked a lot of thoughts when I first read it. So in this book, the central community that we are first introduced to is called Mallard, and this village starts off as a community of colored people, black people who don't look black. They look white. They have red hair, they have blonde hair, they have light skin, and they can pass themselves off as white, but they still choose to identify themselves as colored. At the beginning, I was kind of confused by this because they talked about feeling segregated from the black community, but at the same time, they weren't white. In fact, it actually made me think of an essay I read at the beginning of this year in the book Thick and Other Essays, where I talked about being a mixed black child and how that impacts your identity. I don't think I can elaborate on all the nuances that Tressie McMillan Cotton talked about, but it raised the idea that when you are mixed and you don't look black, sometimes that impacts how the black community views you. And in some ways, when you are mixed, then it can be kind of divisive trying to figure out where you belong and what your identity is. That complexity and confusion is definitely present in The Vanishing Half. We follow two twin sisters. When the twins are growing up, they make the decision to run away from this community and to live in the city. From there, one of the twins ends up making a life for herself by passing herself off as white, while the other goes back to her home village and ends up staying there for most of the rest of her life. I think what the author does a really good job of is that she doesn't provide any judgment on the decisions they make. She really emphasizes how all the actions that the twins have made are justifiable in some way. And I think that nuance is super important when it comes to talking about race and one's own identity within it. Even though the white passing twin ends up marrying a really rich man, living in a big house in a very rich neighborhood, we can see that she still isn't truly happy. She is suppressing a huge part of her identity and lying to everyone in her life in order to maintain her veneer as a white woman. On the other hand, while the other twin is able to fully embrace her identity, her culture, and her history, she still has to deal with the daily reality of racism and systemic injustices. So you can kind of see how both of their actions have consequences. So in that sense, I think this book does such a good job exploring race and making you think about it yourself. Especially considering the year we've had, I think this is an extremely important book to read, to think about, and to talk about. Would highly recommend. So those are some of my favorite books from this year. I filmed a few other book videos in 2020, so there are definitely other books that are extremely strong contenders that I would love to talk about, but I didn't want to make this video too long. So I will leave my book playlist down below in case you're looking for more book recommendations or want to watch other book videos, because I like watching them too. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and that you guys had a great 2020. I'm so excited to see what the new year brings. And if you guys have any video requests or book recommendations, make sure to leave that in the comments down below. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!